We have a look at the grid for the 250 final. Cameron Taylor, Phil Lawrence, Craig Anderson on board the Team Yamaha, and Andrew McFarlane, who's been looking good throughout the night. KTM's second rider in the final, Lee Hogan, Michael Byrne, Mike Jones, and Craig Carmichael. All right, ready to go now, just seconds away. Lee Hogan, anxious, ready to get away to a good start. Must get away to a good start on the inside, but it's Anderson into the first corner. He gets the hole shot. Around the outside goes McFarlane and Jones. Mike Jones has dropped it.
It's not the start he was looking for. It's so hard to come from behind. These guys out front have got a big advantage over Mike Jones now. He's got a lot of work in front of him.
There he is, just got a quick shot of him going out of shot. He was slowing down, looking down, and he has got a lot of work to do, but he's got plenty of time to try and make it up. Craig Anderson hot in pursuit of our race leader, Andy McFarlane, and there's the Castrol KTM rider, Lee Hogan, in third.
McFarlane's improved over the last few weeks. He's had a couple of good placings, and I think it's built his courage up, his confidence up. And now he's out there in the lead. I'm sure he's going to keep it there. He's not going to let Anderson get any sort of advantage over him at all.
Have a look at Team Yamaha's Craig Anderson sitting in second spot, very focused, following McFarlane up and over the tabletop and the adjoining jump, clearing some 25 metres. He's putting the pressure right on McFarlane now, through the stunt as they come. Anderson is right on his hammer at this early stage. Can McFarlane withstand this pressure over the drill? Down! McFarlane, our race leader, is down.
He hit the hay bale with his front brake, locked it up and washed out. It's not a good thing to do, especially when you're in the lead.
Wow, what a bad time to drop the machine. He lost about four or five spots as well. Andrew McFarlane, and there's another position change.
Factory Phil
up into that second spot ahead of his teammate Lee Hogan.
It's Taylor now also back there in fourth. He's put the pressure on Hogan. Keep your eye on Taylor. Having a great night, squeezes up the inside and actually makes a pass stick. I didn't think he was quite far enough in front. He found the legs and got there.
Nice move, Cameron Taylor. So Lee Hogan, he's been so consistent tonight. Factory Phil, great close-up shot there. Hogan has been so consistent, so much so, he's been undefeated until now. He's got a lot of work to do from here, sitting in fourth. This is our main man though, Craig Anderson, in the number one spot. He's the points leader, clears the triples easy, and he's got a bit of room to breathe.
These guys don't have to do an awful lot on the bike as far as gears go. They stay in second from the start, and then all the way through the race, they won't change a gear at all. The outdoor tracks, they go through to second and third through the air, but this track, it's a little easier staying in second.
Phil Lawrence has been to Australia before, some 4 or 5 years ago. He's a consistent top five finisher in the AMA Supercross Series over the past 4 or 5 years. This is his first serious ride in Australia in quite some time. He'd be loving sitting in second spot at the moment.
Keep your eye on Taylor. He's been looking up the inside a couple of times of Phil Lawrence. I don't know, he's trying to work out where he can get past. He might have something in store, I'm not sure. It's very hard to tell these guys what they're actually thinking while they're riding.
This is not really Phil Lawrence's cup of tea, used to riding on much bigger circuits in the USA, but I tell you what, for his first time down under in quite some time, he's handled the conditions extremely well, and we will see him back for the next rounds as well. The next round particularly in Melbourne, as Cameron Taylor comes closer, he draws closer. This 10,000 strong crowd on the edge of their seats as Taylor goes through. He's got the inside run on the KTM rider. Hard on the brakes up into this next section. Lawrence still hangs on to second.
Not quite that time round, but keep your eye on him. As I said, he's looking up the inside there. Always a different line to Phil Lawrence. You can't go through a rider, just have to go around. Squeezes up the inside and makes the pass stick. There he goes, as I said, up the inside. It's a great move. He's thinking awful lot at the moment. That's why I guess he's come away with a win on the 125, and he looks like he's set for a win in the 250.
Taking care of business. How about this guy's form at present? Cameron Taylor just gets on with the job. No fuss, no problems. He's now up in the second spot and trying to chase out after Craig Anderson. There's a lot of ground to catch up. There he is, our number one man. Just one lap left to run. Graham Checkers Stewart, the finishing marshal, putting out the sign. Anderson's just got to hang on for three quarters of a lap and he's home.
Taylor's come from a long way back. He's going to make a last minute effort. Right there, almost hit him as he went through the corner. I don't know if it's going to be enough time, but he's there. Any mistake by Ando and he'll be through.
For a 20-year-old, this guy's incredibly calm, incredibly mature. This is it. He's going to take out the Brisbane round. Craig Anderson, what a win. Great stuff. He'll be very happy with that. That certainly helps his points. Cameron Taylor in for second. Phil Lawrence in for a good third. His KTM teammate Lee Hogan picking up fourth. Fifth was Andrew McFarlane after that fall, ahead of Byrne, Carmichael and Mike Jones, finishing in eighth spot.
I couldn't believe it. I got four starts from four and haven't done that for a while since Sydney. Yeah, in 96 I got every hole shot and I won 9 out of 10 races on 2 nights, and this Yamaha is just the best thing out there. It's unreal to ride, and I just can't believe it that I've won 4 for 4. I won the main.
Yeah, I mean, well, can't complain. I really wanted to win that race pretty bad, but didn't quite get that. I think it's pretty close at the end.
You know, these guys are just really aggressive, and you know, I really wasn't expecting it to be that aggressive, but you know, I handled it okay, and next time I come down under, you know, I'll be a little more used to it, and hopefully I'll come out on top.